Hello to all. Today we are going to discuss some MCQs which are based on the digestive system. This is the part 5. Now first question is casein present in milk, which is means the question wants to ask that this casein is present in milk, which is a bacterium, sugar, protein or a fat. So we must know that casein is a milk protein. Casein is a milk protein. So question number first is having the answer C. Question number two, milk protein. Now we know very well that milk protein is casein. Now milk protein is curdled into calcium paracaseinate. Means whenever we drink milk, okay, then that milk is curdled, means it become curd like, and that curd like substance in the stomach is called as calcium paracaseinate. Now the question is, milk protein, that is known as the casein, is curdled into calcium paracaseinate by maltose, renin, trypsin or lactose. So this curdling of the milk always occur in stomach, and it occurs with the help of renin. It occurs with the help of renin. So question number two is having the answer B, that is renin. Now don't be confused with renin. Renin is actually secreted by the kidney, but renin is found in the stomach, okay, and it converts the milk protein casein into a curd like substance known as the calcium paracaseinate. Now the third one, emulsification of fat. First of all, you know what is emulsification? Conversion of the big droplets of the fats into smaller droplets. Conversion of the big droplets of the fats into smaller droplets is called as emulsification. Now the question is, emulsification of fat by the bile takes place in. You all know that bile juice consists of bile salts, and that bile salts present in bile are responsible for the emulsification of the fat. So emulsification of the fat by the bile takes place in duodenum, liver, stomach and intestine. Now definitely the emulsification of fat never occurs in liver, it never occurs in stomach. Now the confusion is in between the option A and the option D, either in the duodenum or in the intestine. So the emulsification of the fat doesn't occur in the entire part of the intestine. The emulsification of the fat strictly occur in the duodenum part. So the best option for this question is, that is the A, duodenum. Question number 3 is having the answer A. Now coming to question number 4, renin is found in. Just now we have seen that renin converted the milk protein casein into a curd like substance known as the calcium paracaseinate. So definitely the renin is found in liver, kidney, pancreatic juice or gastric juice in stomach. So definitely renin, not renin. If the question was renin, then we might have written the answer kidney. But this is renin, and renin is always found in the gastric juice, which is found in the stomach. So question number 4 is having the answer D. Now tylene. Now tylene is also called as the salivary amylase, and it is found in the saliva. Now this tylene works at a pH of 6.8, which is a slightly acidic pH. Okay. Now the question is, tylene cannot work in stomach because it becomes. Now always remember that enzymes always work at a particular pH. Because of the presence of the HCl in the stomach, which makes the stomach pH 1.5 to 2, this enzyme will not able to work. So tylene cannot work in stomach because it becomes inactive due to HCl. Yes. Inactive due to renin? No. Inactive due to pepsin? None of these. So it becomes inactive due to HCl. So question number 5 is having the answer E. Question number 6. The enzyme trypsinogen is secreted from. Now you know very well that trypsinogen is a proenzyme, inactive enzyme, and later on it is converted into trypsin. The enzyme trypsinogen is secreted from. So the trypsinogen is found in the pancreatic juice, and pancreatic juice is secreted by the pancreas. So definitely the answer must be pancreas. The enzyme trypsinogen is secreted from It is secreted from the pancreas. So the question number 6 is having the answer B, that is pancreas. So these were few important questions related to the digestive system. In the coming days also, not only regarding the digestive system, I will be uploading these type of the MCQ based questions of various topics so that you can have an extra edge for your examination. Thanks a lot.